Hello everyone, I am Dr. Shanta Kumari from Department of Mathematics, AJ Institute of Engineering and Technology, Mangaluru. We already studied Module 1 and Module 2. These two modules were related to the functions of complex variables. In Module 1, we studied differentiation of some complex functions and related conditions. And in Module 2, we studied integration of complex functions as well as the binomial transformation and conformal transformation. Now, let us study module 4, in which we have mainly two topics. One is correlation and second one is fitting of curves. If two quantities are given to you, x and y, if these two quantities vary in such a way that changes in one variable are accompanied by changes in the other variable, then such a variation is called as correlation. For example, the yield of a crop varies with the amount of rainfall. The price of a commodity increases with the reduction in its supply. These are some examples. There are two types of correlations. First one is called as positive correlation and second one is called as negative correlation. If increase of one variable results in increase of the other, or if increase in one variable, decrease in one variable results in decrease of the other, then the correlation is said to be positive. For example, as height increases for a particular person, his weight may also increase. So if you take x as height and y as weight, as x increases, y also increases. In that case, it is a positive correlation. On the other hand, if the variables are varying in such a way that as x increases, y decreases, or as x decreases, y increases, then the correlation is said to be negative. The best example for the present scenario is as the social distance increases, the effect of coronavirus decreases. This is the example for negative correlation. The measure of correlation is called as coefficient of correlation. How to decide whether two given variables are positively correlated or negative correlated? To measure that, we use coefficient of correlation. This coefficient of correlation is given by Carl Pearson. If the data contains x and y, two variables, then formula for computing coefficient of correlation is R equal to summation of x into y divided by n sigma x sigma y. Here, capital X is x minus x bar and capital Y is y minus y bar. In these two formulae, we make use of x bar and y bar. What is x bar here? As you know, x bar is a notation for the average value, mean value. X bar is obtained by adding all x values divided by n. It is average value of x. Similarly, we can find average value of y, adding all y values, then dividing by the number of observations. The denominator term sigma x in this formula denotes the standard deviation of x series. And it is given by this formula. X summation of x minus x bar whole square divided by n actually gives you variance. Square root of variance is called as standard deviation. Similarly, we can find standard deviation of y series, sigma y, which is given by this formula. The denominator term n gives you the number of observations in the given data. And anyway, r is the coefficient of correlation. The value of the coefficient of correlation will be always in between minus 1 and 1. If correlation coefficient is exactly equal to positive 1, then it is called as perfect positive correlation between the variables. Similarly, if R is negative 1, it is perfectly negative correlation between the variables. When R is 0, there is no relationship between the variables. We say that variables are uncorrelated. Now, already we have given one formula for coefficient of correlation in terms of standard deviation of y and capital X capital Y. This is another formula for coefficient of correlation, which is equivalent to the previous formula. One use of this formula is it uses only capital letters X and Y. R is given by summation of X into Y divided by square root of summation of X square into summation of Y square. Here, as usual, capital X is given by X minus X bar and capital Y is given by Y minus Y bar. Now, if a data is given to you with X and Y values, how to find the coefficient of correlation? Either you can make use of first formula or you can make use of this formula. I prefer to use this formula. Now, let us go to one example. Example 1. Data is given to you. Calculate the coefficient of correlation between X and Y using the following data. Data is given. X values are given and Y values are given. I am using the second formula here. To use the second formula, we require capital X and capital Y. Capital X is obtained by using X bar value. So let us first find the average value. So find average value of X. Add all X values here. Then divide by the number of observations. Here there are 8 observations. So summation of X by N, it gives you 832 divided by 8. Answer is 104. So mean value of X is 104. Similarly, mean value of Y, Y bar, it is given by summation of all Y values divided by number of observations. 120 by 8, which is 15. Now using this X bar and Y bar, create the table of values. One column X values, another column Y values. These two columns are the given data. Now remaining extra columns, we calculate capital X, X minus X bar. So from each X value given here, subtract X bar, that means 104, and write the values in this column. And square of this column, we prepare another column, X square column. Similarly, from each Y value given here, subtract Y bar. Y bar is 15. So subtract 15 from each value under this column Y and write the values here. This gives you capital Y. You can see that some values are positive and some values are negative depending on the subtracted answer. Again, square this value, Y square. Prepare your column, Y square column. Multiply capital X column and capital Y column values and prepare XY column. So after completing this table, we need to find the sum under X square column. Sum under X square column, we get 120. Sum under Y square column, we get 184. And summation under XY column, we get minus 92. Now using the second formula for coefficient of correlation, which is summation of X into Y divided by square root of summation of X square into summation of Y square, Substitute the values obtained from the table. Substitute the values and we get the answer as minus 0.619. As I told you, coefficient of correlation always lies in between minus 1 and 1. You cannot get any answer less than minus 1 or more than positive 1. So here our answer is minus 0.619. That means X and Y are negatively correlated. So this is one example. So dear students, what you can do here is prepare the table of values yourself using the calculator and just verify whether the answer obtained here is correct. Now for your practice, I am giving you one more example. Example 2, similar data is given, X and Y values are given here and it is required to find the coefficient of correlation between X and Y. So first find X bar and Y bar as usual. Mean value of X and mean value of Y, then try to prepare this table. So what you can do here is pause this video for a while, use the calculator, prepare the table yourself, then check whether your values are correct. So don't just go through the table without calculating. Calculate each column yourself, check whether your values are correct. So here coefficient of correlation is given by 0.896 positive. So this is an example for positive correlation. As an extra example, I have given here the data containing psychological tests of intelligence and engineering ability, which are applied to 10 students. Here is a record of ungrouped data showing intelligence ratio IR and engineering ratio ER. Here data is given to you, this table is given to you. 10 students' name are given, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. 10 students' name are given. For each student, values of X and values of Y. X is intelligence ratio and Y is engineering ratio. It is given. Now, actually, we need only this X and Y values for calculating the coefficient of correlation. So, let us prepare the table as usual, as we have worked out in the previous problem. Prepare X column, Y column, capital X, capital Y, capital X square column, Y square column and capital XY column. Pause this video, prepare the table yourself, then compare the values with this table. Finally, while applying this formula, we get the coefficient of correlation as 0.59.